Yeah. See the river? Oh, this is going to be perfect. It's going to be awesome.
Feed it through the machine. Make sure it goes through all the nooks and crannies.
It first started off about a year ago when I had to work on my 16mm Bolex project for cinematography. And with that one, I was just kind of playing off the idea of guy kind of just comes in, hitman, played with light and darkness, kind of shadows and camera angles. I just really liked how quickly I put that story together and how cinematically it just looked on screen when we actually played back our footage. And after that, I was like, I kind of want to actually go in depth and like discover more about the hitman. Just envision in my head, like, oh, how amazing would it be just to see someone get shot in the knee, then set on fire and have to drag himself to the water to save his own life when it's literally only 10 feet away. And people today just, we walk 10 feet just to go change the channel or grab something from the fridge and come back to the couch. So it's a small amount of distance, but when you put that, like, my life is rested in making it that 10 feet. I was like, how can I do this? How can I create that sense of feeling to, like, create this suspense just for the audience?
I don't know why I seem surprised that I bought fake blood to look like blood. And I'm like, wow, it does look like blood. Like,
really? I don't know. I amaze myself sometimes. Here goes.
Then he got a pretty good trumpet at the end, too.
But only when it wants to.
So, yeah. So, we'll review the footage and
see how it goes. And then, as you can see, my knee is somewhat bleeding. I'm perfectly fine though, fans. Don't worry about me. I'll kick on right back. That made no sense. I'll keep coming back. Oh, yeah.
Cold.
Okay.
Alright. Can you do it again?
Let's see. Let's see. You can shoot yourself.
Oh, you can just run like that?
Yeah.
Should I shoot you some more?
Can you see the hose at all?
How can I do this? How can I create that sense of feeling to, like, create this suspense just for the audience? And so I originally pitched it to the class because I was like, I want to try this.
Fire ice powder mix from the mail that I got, and I have a little bit of water in here. So I'm just gonna add a little bit of powder. This makes basically a nice, it absorbs the water and creates a gel to prevent fire seeping in. It's easy to be washed off with just straight water, and you can apparently eat it as well. And on their test footage, one of the news reporters that was reviewing it actually ate it herself. I'm just going to take her word for it. She says it was basically like water applesauce. What I'll be doing is I'll take this and I'll be rubbing it on my arm to create that gel barrier. And then I will be lighting my fuel source, coating my arm in the gel. Are you guys ready? Yeah. And right now, I'm actually not feeling any heat from my actual arm at all, but I see that the shirt is kind of burning. So, like the most, just kind of got scared a little bit there, but okay.
Good stuff.
Oh, and later on they send out a message, do not eat the product.
Just a weird texture is all that.
Yeah.
Literally no taste.
Kind of really
there's virtually no taste. The texture.
Yeah, there is no taste. Weird. It's weird.
Right when that glue takes off, light, I want you to yell as loud as you can and say, you're on fire. No. Just say, go. And everything. That way I'll know flames are a go. I'll start moving around. Drew, you'll be holding this water blanket. Yeah. Basically, you'll follow me around. At any point I feel heat or I'm getting burnt or anything, I'm gonna just instantly start moving down to the ground. That will be your cue to come in, throw the blanket down, start patting me.
After we do this, we gotta just be like, this kid's on fire!
Let's get as many kids running over here as we can. Same as the other day, wind.
Yeah, but I want this.
Oh, we're taking the pants off?
Yeah. Oh, we're taking the pants off.
Oh my god.
Those pants. This is what it takes.
Oh my god, that's dedication.
Don't worry, this stuff comes off. Like, could someone just please help me with my back?
God damn it.
Thanks, Morgan.
Brim's looking pretty
good. We've already been through so much together.
All right. Go.
Let's do this, boys.
That was bad.
For now, maybe we might actually have to use a lighter.
I'm gonna be doing a stunt. Fire!
Okay, here we go.
Evan, careful. Oh my god.
It keeps going out.
It's going out. All right. Ready?
Ready.
Go! Safely. Originally in my script I wanted a lake, but since the area that I'm at and with my crew cast and all that, I couldn't actually get to a lake. So this is close enough. It's the river, so I had to change it up a bit. It's a good location. I like it. Not too far away, and that way I don't have to pay for lodging or housing for anyone while we're working on this.
But no, like visually, this will be freaking awesome with how dark it is. Because, we got like this going downhill. You can start like, I'm on fire, You got the steam coming off, so you'll have steam coming off the flames. You have that play with the snow on the ground.
And then Tyler would be just kind of walking alongside, just watching him on fire, just struggling. Maybe crouching here, just watching. Hand just drops. He's dead and just looking around and just pop. Shoots him in the head and just kind of walks away. Dead body burning down in there in the background. We could just stuff clothes with logs. Have the logs burning, just the body shape kind of.
Mm-hmm.
and close, and him just holding the revolver. And that's when he goes back into his flashbacks, because that was one thing they were talking about in the script critique, is that the montage should not be at the very end, but kind of intertwined, cutting back and forth, which I originally had that idea. I just threw it in there in the script, just be like the, well, I know how I want to kind of edit it, but just script-wise, here's to read it, and everyone's like freaking out. I was like, oh, it's not in the way it's supposed to be added. Wow. On to the next memory. Click. Next memory. Click. And then, like, after, like, he finally, like, survives, pulls out a piece of paper, crosses off Collins, Ramirez's name, and then just kind of walks back to the vehicle. I like that. I'm liking this. I like that tree, and I like the angle going down.
Hello, viewers and listeners of Cody Film Productions. We are here following Connor in his Connor's extra lovely vehicle, recently manufactured and patent holding.
My name is Tyler Martin. Spell that with an O. I will be an assassin. I'm just your average guy that's got long hair and a shaggy beard and wears a tie and kills people.
I really like to work with him. He's fun, and the ideas that he comes up with are really creative.
If he sees an image and I fit into that somehow, I feel honored to fulfill that.
I feel the other guy should be a lot more nervous. All I do is throw a match. And I feel like if things go horribly wrong, I would regret that for the rest of my life. But I've seen a little bit of stuff on Facebook of Connor lighting himself on fire at the parking lot over by the pool. And he was completely calm. That's the thing. Connor's really meticulous with if he's gonna try a stunt or do something different, but I'm not nervous.
Well, the road's closed. I even checked and like it didn't say that they were closing this week at all.
So Connor does do good planning. It's just people didn't let him know.
Finds a way.
We could film in the rattlesnake.
The rattlesnake?
Yeah. Rattlesnake has good wooded areas.
I like this because, like, I mean, like, there's the boat launch where you could, like, drive up.
True.
Like, right to it. There was the valley. There, it was away from, like, everything to where... I was getting excited because I mean we have like this parking lot right here where we could have people parked. I mean, yeah, this is a long walk. When it was the Russian roulette thing,
yeah,
that you would be like up here, like where Cody is right now. That would be like the burning body, and you'd just be like looking at it, and then you'd just be spinning the chamber, click, click. But of course that's off. But I do like the visual, so maybe, I don't know, this is kind of like where like you could have like your mental breakdown.
So we found out today that we're not gonna have the professionals on set tomorrow when we do the fire stuff, so like no professionals. It's just stupid to do it without like any safety precautions or people that know what they're doing, you know.
Here. I checked with the park services and all that, and they said that the gate would still be open for a couple more weeks. That was not the case. When I got here, the gate was closed, so none of our vehicles could come down.
I was going to hope to use my car or a car headlight as the main light source, just because they're pretty powerful. And it looked really good on the test footage when we were location scouting. But with the gate being closed, couldn't get in there. So we had to try and get around that obstacle. So I just got all the equipment, brought it down here, tried to set it up, tried to use my light source that I was going to just use as fill lights as my main. Basically, right when we got everything set up, the batteries died. We didn't have enough light source to do anything. A lot of wrenches were just thrown into the machine this week, and I tried to get what I could, but just didn't happen, I guess. Not enough planning, not enough people. I've been trying to keep it together today, but it's just been one giant crap fest after another, and I want to take a break from it, but I know I need to keep trying to get at least some stuff filmed. So I just gotta push on forward. Was it in focus and all that?
Yeah, I think
awesome.
So.
Awesome. Cool.